Welcome to Energy and the Environment, a program dedicated to exploring energy issues and their impact on our nation's environment. I'm your host, Brent Watson. Today's subject on energy and the environment is Synfuels, their outlook for the 80s. To help me explore this subject, our guest today is Dr. J.B. O'Hara of the Ralph M. Parsons Company. Dr. O'Hara is an energy engineer manager with 32 years' experience in developing and managing various energy projects, both here and abroad. Dr. O'Hara is currently working to provide commercial-scale Synfuel plants to industry. He's the author of 75 publications and an expert in energy technology and economics. Dr. O'Hara, could we begin by defining the term Synfuels?
I'd be pleased to. Synfuel is an abbreviation of the words synthetic fuel. Historically, we've obtained our fuels from petroleum sources such as crude oil and natural gas. Now, a Synfuel is the equivalent of a petroleum-based fuel, but it's produced from an alternate source such as coal.
Well, what are some of the raw materials that can be used to create Synfuels?
There are a number of sources for Synfuels, including tar sands and biomass. But the principal U.S. sources, the ones that can produce enormous amounts of fuel, are coal and oil shale.
What about the pollution factors associated with Synfuels?
The Synfuels industry is proceeding carefully to ensure the plants built will meet environmental requirements. Industry will work closely with government in this area. Industry has already analyzed a number of preliminary designs for coal liquid plants to find out what pollutants could result and how they should be treated. We believe it is possible to meet environmental standards at liquid coal plants.
What about the current outlook for Synfuels? Can we expect Synfuels to play a significant energy role in the near future?
The Synfuels industry is just being born in this country. But this infant industry is expected to begin to play a role in our energy program before the 1980s end. Current goals are to produce the equivalent of 500,000 barrels of oil per day by 1987 and 2 million barrels per day by 1992.
Well, then, can you tell me what happens if we don't create an operational Synfuels program? Can we manage without one?
Well, in my judgment, only with a high risk to our national security and our economy. At the present time, approximately 60% of the world's merchant oil is produced in the volatile Middle East. We've already experienced two major interruptions in Middle East production, and most experts agree that our energy demand and our energy supply will remain in a delicate balance for the next 10 to 15 years. The Synfuels program will allow us to get through these difficult times and give us more strength in negotiating with the oil-producing nations.
I'm Brent Watson, and we've been talking today with Dr. J.B. O'Hara. Dr. O'Hara is an energy engineer manager and is an expert on the subject of Synfuels. The name of the program, Energy and the Environment. A public information program brought to you by Dames & Moore, an energy and environmental consulting firm in cooperation with this station.